So I'm excited. I'm sure Slipknot will be excited soon enough. Because you, I know why you clicked on this video. You want to see Slipknot, my 12-foot reticulated python, get a nice, large arboreal enclosure that he deserves. So his current enclosure is 8 feet wide, 2 feet deep, and 18 inches tall. And since he is a 12-foot male mainland reticulated python, he definitely deserves something bigger. And I'm going to give it to him. So his new enclosure is going to be 8 feet wide, 3 feet deep, and 30 inches tall. For example, this enclosure right here is 30 inches tall. I got all these branches that I got from RnRBranches. I will put a link in the description. So, all right, let's get in the garage and make Slipknot a new proper home. Back in the shop, and time to turn the stack of wood right here into a reticulated python enclosure. Also, My little helper over here is gonna be helping me with a 6x2x2 reptile enclosure kit for one of my customers as well. So we're gonna be doing a little multitasking, but it's necessary to keep the business running. Also, if you're interested in a reptile DIY or a custom reptile enclosure kit, I have many different sizes on my website, talkingserpents.com, and there will be a link down in the description. All right, let's cut some wood.
Okay.
So I'm currently building two enclosures right now. One is for Slipknot, and the other is for one of my customers. It is a 6x2x2 DIY reptile enclosure kit. So, gotta take care of my customers first, so let's go build that now. Or, wait, actually, have you ever seen like one of those crummy infomercials, and they show you something that they are making, or let's just say baking, you're baking like a pie or something, and they throw it in the oven, and then all of a sudden they just, from under the counter, they just pull out a pie. Well, that's this moment. All right, there you go, it's all finished. So this is the 6x2x2 DIY reptile enclosure kit. Just gotta put the window track on and put the glass in, and this thing's ready to go. So now we can get back to working on Slipknot's enclosure. Back to this pile of wood. Got everything prepped, ready to go. So, time to build this thing. Let's make it snappy. You ready? In 3, 2, 1. Well, there you go. Structure's all together. Looking good. Oh man, this thing is definitely a maximum upgrade from my reticulated python, and he definitely deserves it. Got a full-size human in there for size reference, with a lot of room to spare, and I'm really excited about that. So I got a 6-inch lower substrate barrier and 4-inch trim on the outside edges. I want maximum viewing space to see him in his epic enclosure. Doesn't look like much now, but there's gonna be a lot of detail that goes into this, and I'm not trying to think about it too much because it's gonna make my head go crazy. So one step at a time, 1 foot in front of the other, and we will get to the end of that road. All right, so now I'm gonna be putting a coat on the inside that is polyurethane. That's gonna be the interior sealant, like I normally do. And then I'm gonna put vinyl tiles to match the rest of my enclosures inside. All right, it's time to get to work. Well, time for a progress update, and it's gonna be a satisfying one. So like I said, I did the clear interior sealant, so I have 1 coat of that, nice thick sealant. And then I got the vinyl tiles on the back, right and left side walls, they're looking good. And got my white waterproof flooring in. So, I'm just gonna stop right there. Sometimes people ask me where I get these tiles. I get them at Home Depot. They're vinyl tiles. And the reason why I don't add them onto my own custom enclosures on my website, talkingserpents.com, is because they take a lot of time and they are heavy, quite a bit heavier, and I don't wanna ship them. Not only that, you need to have like a pneumatic stapler to put them on properly, stainless steel staples so they don't rust. Okay, go ahead and just drop that thing. Yeah, does that sound heavy?
It's heavy.
It is heavy, and that's why I don't add them on my website as an option, because it is also really time consuming. This honestly took more hours than I would like to admit, but it looks good, and gotta continue with the theme of the rest of my enclosures. As you can see, I also have a couple enclosures over here. I've been taking care of my customers. This one is a 4 foot wide, 3 foot deep, and 2 foot tall, 4x2x2 DIY reptile enclosure kit with some glass in there. Just been super, super busy this week. Just so many things going on. There we go, just adjusted, the lighting was a little off. So this is another thing I've been working on. This is a 4 foot wide, 2 foot deep, and 4 foot tall arboreal reptile enclosure. You got the quarter inch sliding glass, doors are all tempered, and sorry the lighting's bad, but it's a gray interior sealant, weathered gray stain, looks phenomenal. Love that color scheme. And I got my dog that wants to play right now. We always wanna play. Gotta love it. So then this enclosure up here on top is 6 feet wide, 3 feet deep, and 18 inches tall for a tortoise. And then down here I got a 6x2x2 DIY reptile enclosure kit with a couple sets of dual quarter inch sliding glass doors going for a woma python. I'm really excited about that one. Oh, more new stuff. Actually, a lot of new stuff going on. So this down here is a 3 foot wide, 2 foot deep, and 18 inch tall. That's another new reptile enclosure kit size. It is available on my website, talkingserpents.com. So is this one, this little custom one, ready to go. Probably by the time this video is out, probably won't be on there. But anyways, what's the new thing? Oh, Stephanie, what are you wearing? So after about 6 months or so, we now have new apparel. This is the venomous, it has all the different venomous snakes listed on there. I have a snake one. They come in all different sizes, colors for men's, women's, youth, you name it. We got everything covered if you're available. Of course, it's on the website. And my favorite thing, I'll show you right now. All right, so here is yet another new product. I'm telling you, all this is in 1 week. We're really busy, but I'm really excited about this one. This is the new bulb guard design. This is a heavier gauge mesh material, black PVC coating. All the hardware is corrosion resistant, but that's not why I'm excited. It's this part. So now you can go in there and easily change your heating element. Very easy. Let's hook this thing back up. Boom. Your reptile cannot get in. The old bulb guard design still worked great. I still have them on all my reptile enclosures, but you used to have to like slightly unscrew the little screws that secure this thing to the ceiling, finagle this thing off. It's kind of annoying. But now it's easy, looks good. Everything's just all around improved. So it's 100% new and three times as good. So I'm really excited about it. If you have purchased a heat bulb kit from me in the past, you can go ahead and just purchase just the bulb guard. I have the bulb guard alone, and then I have full heat bulb kits with the new design. And yes, they are all interchangeable. So if you have the old design, it will work with the new design. So yeah, like I'm kind of suggesting that it's definitely been more than a few days since the last time I even worked on Slipknot's enclosure. I've just been ultra busy with running the business. Got to take care of my customers first. So I'm gonna package all these enclosures. Don't worry, you don't have to be here for that because it's not fun. But yeah, next stop, we back at Slipknot's enclosure working on that. Back to working on Slipknot's enclosure. So I'm gonna be building a shelf on the right side and the left side, and then a shelf on the top. That way he can climb on top of the upper shelf and go to, you know what, it's better just to show than it is to tell. Also, I'm not going to build some shelves. I already built them. That's YouTube magic right there. So there's that one and that one. They're nice and strong. You know what? This only means one thing. Let's snap them in 3, 2, 1. Here we go, looking good. Oh, looking extra good. So we're gonna have a shelf. It's gonna be about that high, all the way across, maybe about 10 inches wide. And that way, Slipknot can go from this over the top and down, and then you can climb around. And you know, there's gonna be a lot of other things in here. And like I said, it's better to show than it is to tell, so let's get back to work. All right, and the center shelf is built. And it is awesome. Love it. So now he could be on the left side or the right side and go climb across. He can coil up there, elongated, whatever he wants. All right, and also it is strong, so I'm happy. Definitely needs to be strong for a 12-foot reticulated python. And then now time to take these things off, sand them, and I'm gonna do a gray interior sealant, and it should match the interior of this enclosure perfectly. So right now we're having a really, really important business meeting inside Slipknot's new enclosure. The dog's just kind of elaborate. Are you sleeping on the job? Oh my God. But seriously, yeah, we came in here to brainstorm some ideas on where we're gonna be putting the branches and all the electrical and the air ventilation. And we pretty much figured out that there is, this is gonna be a long video. So this is actually going to be a two-part video. And we're going to have to pick up again because I don't think anybody wants to watch a 45 minute video because I don't. I don't know, I could be wrong, but yeah, it's a big job. I haven't even talked about getting into the room. Well, stay tuned for that. All right, well, this is definitely not awkward in here. I think the snake's gonna be happy. All right, if you like the video, strike that like button. If you have any comments, post in the comment section below. Please do subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.